creating App Store screenshots and keeping them up to date can be a huge pain, especially if they're highly customized and if you support multiple localizations. In this video, I'm going to talk about an approach that I actually started working on about a year ago and then put to the side, but now I'm back on it. It's called Blacksmith, and it's a solution within Xcode to programmatically, automatically create your App Store screenshots. They are always up to date and they support all of your localizations. It's super easy to set up and very quick to work with. So I've basically got the standard empty Xcode project right here. The only thing that I have changed is added a localizable.strings file with the German translation for hello world, which is hallo Welt. And as you can see right here, it's the German localization. And then in our preview provider, I have actually added the German locale, which is super easy. I didn't actually know how to do this before starting to record this video. Just add the environment modifier and access the .locale environment value and set it to your locale that you want to preview. Very nice stuff. I definitely didn't know about that beforehand. But I just did that so I can later on show you how you can localize your screenshots as well. So the first thing that you will have to do is create a new UI testing target if you don't have that already. Even if you do, I might recommend to actually create a new one since we aren't doing UI tests here. We're just using that framework to create our App Store screenshots. So if you want to separate that from your actual UI tests, I recommend to create a new target here. So let's say file, new target, and then let's just search for UI testing bundle. Does not matter whatsoever how we call it, so let's just say finish here, and then we have our testing bundle over here, and we already have two files. We don't care about the launch tests, but we care about this XC test case here, and we can actually get rid of almost everything except for the test example function. We do not care about the rest. Okay, so now that we have our UI test set up, and let me quickly tell you something about this. All of the setup that we're going through right now, you only have to do a single time, and then all of your screenshots will always be up to date. You just have to rerun your UI tests and grab the screenshot files. So just one time to do this setup, and then they will always stay up to date. So what we will have to do is add Blacksmith to our project, and I'm not distributing it as a Swift package right now. I'm just distributing it as a folder of files. So you just grab that folder and drag and drop it into your testing target, and make sure to select copy items if needed. And really important, make sure that it's added to your UI testing target. And there we have it, the Blacksmith package. There are a few different things in here, actually not that fancy, but the approach is very interesting in my opinion. So now that we have added these files, let me explain to you how everything works. So what you basically do is you launch the application and you tell it which language to launch in or which locale to use. Then, as you would always do in your UI test, you just navigate to wherever you want to be in your app. We are skipping this part in this video, but I'm sure there are plenty of videos out there on how to navigate in your app through UI tests. It's just basically uses the accessibility labels of all of your buttons and so on. You can have a look at that later on. We will just do a simple example in this video. And then once you have basically reached the screen, you take a screenshot using the screenshot function as part of XC test. And then you put that screenshot in a SwiftUI view, and this is where the magic happens. Now you can design your App Store screenshots with your device frames, with titles, with images in the background, whatever you want. You can design them in SwiftUI now. Also works with UIKit, of course. And then you take a screenshot of that and save it as an attachment. Now this is where things might get a bit more complicated, but we will have a look at that once we get there. So first of all, let's rename this function here, and I believe we need to keep the test prefix in order to be able to run it as a UI test. Not entirely sure about that. And then the rest of the function I would just rename to whatever screen you are trying to create here. So in our case, let's say test content view, because we just have a content view in this project and we're not navigating to any other screens. Next, you need to think about the localizations that you want to add, and for that Blacksmith has a localization type. So let's say let localizations equals an array, and let's create a localization with a locale, which is the locale identifier, so EN for English, and then a title. Let's add just first image, just an example, whatever title, whatever text you want to have on your screenshot in the end. And then let's create a second one for a DE, which is German. And here we just say erstes Bild, also first image, but in German. Okay, so now that we have the localizations set up, let's grab this piece of code here because we will need it later on. And now we can say for localization in localizations and paste that back in. This is where something really interesting now happens, and it's that we're telling the app which language or which localization it should launch in. We can just say app.launch arguments, and this is an array, and it's probably some very old stuff since it's string based, but we will say Apple languages, and then we will have to add the localization dot locale here. And just like that, we're telling the simulator to launch our application in the language that we have specified. So first loop will be in English, second loop will be in German. Okay, and then we can already launch the app. Now, this is where you would navigate to your screen. We don't have to do that since our app only has a content view, but you would here then grab your window and click on buttons or whatever you have to do. We're skipping this part. Okay, the next step is to just create a screenshot like you would always do in your UI tests. So let's say let screenshot equals app.screenshot. Doesn't get any easier than this, right? From here on out, we have two options. We can either use the built-in export with title, which is just your screenshot, some background and a title above or below, or you can create your own SwiftUI view and export that in the end. I will show you both approaches. So first, quick export, let's call this one default. And here we just say screenshot.quickexport with title, and the title is of course our localization.title. So first image for the English localization, erstes Bild for the German localization. For the background, we can select what we want. There are a few different options, color, gradient, or an image. I will just add a plain color. So let's say we want it to be blue. For the export size, you can choose Mac, iPhone, or you can create your custom size that you want in case it ever changes in App Store Connect. So I will just use .iPhone. And then alignment is where your title is placed, if it's placed above or below the screenshot. So in this example, let's just say title above. And then this function here creates an XCT attachment. So we can say let attachment equals this thing. And if we now option click on it, we can see it's an XCT attachment. These are basically files or screenshots that you can add to your test cases so you can work with them later on. And now that we have this attachment, we can just say add or attachment. This will not compile because the attachment is optional, so we will just say if, and then only do it if we actually got the attachment. So this is the option to do a quick export with just your screenshot and a title above. Second option is to create your own SwiftUI view and export that. So let's have a look at that next. For that, we will select our export size and we will once again say iPhone since this is an iOS project. And then we will create a capturing view, which is the example that is built into Blacksmith, but really you could use any SwiftUI view that you want. You can just have a look at the source code to see how it works. So let's say let capturing view, and this is basically the actual screenshot for App Store Connect in the end. This is just a screenshot with a title, and this takes in a bunch of parameters. So let me align them nicely for you. Okay, so first of all, it takes in a title, which is once again our localization.title. Then it takes in an image, which is our screenshot.image. This is a UI image, and we actually need to convert that to a SwiftUI image. So we will just do it like this, I believe. Or do we have to add the UI image thing? I think like this. And then, of course, we also need to import SwiftUI. For the background, we will once again just choose .color.blue, and for the export size we will just pass in our export size. You can also of course just say .iPhone here and then get rid of that variable above. And having a look at this screenshot with title, what actually is this? This is just a SwiftUI view, which conforms to the capturing view protocol. Capturing view only needs you to have an export size. And then in here, this is just our initializer. The body is just our background. Then the title above or below and the image. Nothing fancy. This is where you can create your completely customized styling, completely customized screenshot written in SwiftUI. Of course, UIKit is also possible. So now that we have our view, which we want to have as our screenshot in the end, we can just use the create marketing image function, which once again returns us an attachment. This function is built into Blacksmith as the image we just pass in our view. So here we called it our capturing view, and the export size is once again .iPhone. This gets us an attachment, and it's actually not optional in this case, so we can just say add attachment. And then once we're done with everything, we cannot forget to actually terminate the app again. So just say app.terminate, and everything here happens inside of our for loop. All right, so now you have set up your first screenshot, and this is something you only have to do a single time, and then you can reuse this piece of code every time your app UI changed or you want to add new localizations. So since we obviously don't want both approaches, I will just remove the custom export approach, and we will just be using the quick export with title function. Okay, so now we will just run this UI test in order to create our attachments. So just go to this little icon here and hit play, and this will now launch the simulator and actually run your UI testing suite. And there we could see the English localization and now also the German localization. And it looks like the test was now completed. And having a look at the log down here in the console, we can see an attachment named first image was added, and then an attachment named erstes Bild was added. Now this next part is the only thing that's a bit painful with this approach, because as of Xcode 11, we're not really able to access these images without any other tools. So there are a few steps that we now have to go through, but I think once you have memorized them, it's still so much faster than actually making these images yourself. So for that, we just go to the Xcode settings and go to the locations tab, just to go to our derived folder or derived data folder right here. Just press this little arrow icon and then the derived data folder will open up, and we will open that folder, and now we will search for our app project. So mine is this one here, BS app. So let's open that. In here we will go to logs, to test, and then you can see our test exe result file here, and I will actually rename this to example.exe result. And then we can get the info for this here, just to grab our path. So copy that path, and now to actually extract the screenshots out of this exe result file, we will be using the xcparse homebrew package. Don't worry, it's a one-liner for installing it, and you only need to install it once, obviously. So just run brew install chargepoint /xcparse/xcparse in your terminal, and then you can actually stay in your terminal and already use xcparse and just paste in your path that you just copied for your exe result file, and then also add example.exe result, and then we will be saving this, for example, to the desktop. And let me make sure that that folder exists. All right, and now just run this function. Oops, I forgot that you need to add the dash s argument. All right, so let's run this now. And there we see exporting completed, and now we can just open Finder and have a look at our screenshots. All right, so now there is a folder called test screenshots, and if we open that, we have our first image, and we have our erstes Bild, and of course the app is also localized because we launched it in the correct language. Now this might not be the prettiest App Store screenshot here, and I 100% agree with you. This is just the example that you have for free inside of Blacksmith. You can go completely crazy here, create your own SwiftUI views for the layout of your titles. You can add a device frame, of course, just import that as an image to your UI test target as an asset, and then do whatever you want. You can rotate the device, you can add some shadows, whatever you want. This is just the example that you get for free by using the quick export with title function or the screenshot with title view. And if you want to customize it, you can just have a look into the views folder here, and you can just take this screenshot with title and change it to however you want it to be for your layout. You can, for example, change the font of your title, but you could actually already do that with our current setup. You can just add the font parameter and, for example, large title, whatever. But this way you can customize your screenshots completely with code, export them completely automatically, including localizations of both the text on your screenshot and your app. And then the only thing you need to do is actually convert your .exe result back to your PNG files, which, let's be honest, takes 1 minute. Writing these test cases here might take a tiny bit of time, depending on how complex you want your app store screenshots to be. But remember, you can reuse this every single time. You don't have to change anything, and you will never have to take screenshots of your simulator ever again and paste them into Figma, Sketch, or whatever image editing software you're using. If you enjoyed this, you can find it in the link down below in the video description, also in the pinned comment. You can have access to Blacksmith there. If you're using it, be sure to leave me a comment and also leave some suggestions of how I could potentially improve this tool.